Bruce Perens was one of the first people whose analysis I read about the deal. And back then he set up a petition, in addition to the Technocrat article or post, he penned, I think, that the following day, so probably the 3rd of November, if that's still available online, I'm not sure, but I know he did actually withdraw some of his sites and brought them back online and offline, so who knows what. But the this was very influential from my point of view, because he was talking about the effects of the patents and making a comparison to things like the SCO situation in court. So what I then realized is that based on this analysis, there is no way for me to kind of sympathize with Novell or to try and understand what they did. The next goal in many people's minds, as well as people who signed the petition, myself included, I was one of the first people to sign it, we have to try and push against the deal, to withdraw the deal, to revoke by Novell. And we were working on mailing lists and trying to convince the company to do something about it. And I think it was, I'm not sure who it was, but somebody told us it's irrevocable. And I think it was an Andreas who said that. He was one of the main people in the SUSE community, one of the people who were working for Novell at the time, so he had some influence. And it wasn't possible, so we did realize that we need to try and compel Novell to change its mind and to reduce this risk, basically, just created for all the rival distributions of GNU/Linux. So this is why I got involved in Boycott Novell. And I don't really know if there is so much I can tell about running of the sites. I mean, people have usually seen, so I suppose most people have seen the site over the years and kind of know what it's about. So I could probably just skip over many of the acts of Novell and what he did, and talk about the later days of Novell, and how he basically betrayed Novell, betrayed the community, even when the end of Novell was basically imminent.